creepy gnome investigator nonchalantly gives you a head start, then goes back to work on the crime scene. What is really going on here? The air suddenly grows warmer. A draft rises from somewhere below. You have a sense that you're being watched. More so than usual. Your recent encounters with an odd gnome inquisitive and undead spirits notwithstanding. This must be the place where Evan went for a drink. Perhaps the bartender has seen him. You turn to head outside, only to find a man standing in your path. He beckons you over. A steady gust of wind pushes you away from the enchanted construction site. No doubt it's a clever way to avoid liability for accidents. Strange. What's a treasure chest like that doing in a place like this? You find yourself in a small corner of the vast sewers that snake beneath the city. If your suspicions are correct, the mysterious House Tarkanon has a hideout somewhere nearby.
Look what the cat dragged in.
The crouching half-orc barely seems to be paying attention to you.
How's the weather topside?
Thank you.
At first, Lady Thora gapes at you like a startled deer. Then she sighs with exasperation.
Cursed contractors. If you want something done right, you've got to do it yourself.
We had a deal, Talion.
Thora calls out when she sees the gnome inquisitive among the attackers.
Nobody quits the Dark Lantern, Thora. You're a loose end, Talion responds. And you're done playing house.
All of them, at least for today. We need to keep moving, Thora says. If you want to talk to Evan, you need to do it now.
High Priest gestures to the east.
Take the sky coach at the end of the northern courtyard. It will deliver you to your destination.
One of Sharn's most powerful men has turned against Lucien Vaunt and has selected you to deliver the killing blow against his new manufactory. You arrive at your destination after a long flight through the forest of towers that comprises the Middle Memphis district. To your surprise, Vaunt's Dura warehouse is a drab and unremarkable structure. The entrance is unguarded, so you slip inside. After a moment of stunned silence, the guards scramble into action.
Intruders! Activate the alarm spells! Lock down the entire tower!
Pulling the ornate lever triggers a suspicious rumbling in the hall behind you. You've uncovered a secret passage. A large group of guards has formed ranks in front of the tower's lower doors.
Defend the doors!
One shouts in command.
Don't let them pass!
Pushing open the doors unleashes a wave of hot air. The heat reminds you more of your time down in the cogs than of the middle city. Flooring suddenly gives way beneath your feet. The rumble and clank of machinery grows louder as you move further down the passage. As you open the first valve, the pipes in the room begin to rupture and steam hisses from the cracks. Another pipe breaks, and the machinery itself begins to shudder. Pulling the final lever causes the temperature in the room to flare up as the system breaks down. You have reached the center of the manufactory. Sabotaging the equipment in here should disable the whole facility. The machinery loudly grinds and squeaks. Acrid smoke pours from the sabotaged equipment. Arcane lightning crackles through the grating as the device overcharges and melts. The last piece of equipment in the main manufactory sputters and stalls. Soon, the entire tower starts to quake. Rupturous heat and concussive force tear through the building as the main manufactory collapses. gnome roars at you as you enter the room.
My wonderful equipment! How could you destroy it like that? You'll pay for this travesty!
The massive construct emits a strange metallic grating sound, and several smaller constructs begin barreling into the chamber. The construct finally grinds to a halt, too damaged to continue its assault.